When setting up a great looking shot, it's important to be aware of the dimension of the shot. Are there objects in the foreground, middle ground, and background? Especially for shots with camera moves, having three-dimensional depth to your shots can really enhance the beauty and production value of a shot. Now, ultimately, what's going on in the shot and what it looks like is a decision to be made by the director with the assistance of the production designer. But from my experience on a lot of amateur productions, people just tend to not have that much experience and don't know what to look for. So it's your job to contribute ideas to make the visuals of the film more potent. And depth is a great way to do that that is often neglected. For this shot of the preacher at night in the assurance, we had extras run in front of him and also behind him. That made him the middle ground. The depth here makes the shot much more compelling to me. Likewise, with the deleted shot of the preacher falling to the ground, an extra ran in front that establishes the foreground, and then there's smoke and fire in the midground, and the preacher is behind that, and there's also woods behind the preacher, even though they're not really prominent. Big budget movies have a much easier time with this because they can afford spacious locations. I love the dimension in this shot from The Last Emperor. We have the parallax created by rows of people walking combined with an out-of-focus foreground and a distant background of soldiers and a wall. Or this gorgeous shot from The Revenant, with this guy here in the foreground. And you know, we got Leo and some trees in the middle ground, and more trees and mountains in the distant background. Or this shot from Black Narcissus, with the subjects in the foreground, plants in the extreme foreground, people and buildings in the middle ground, and then beautiful mountains and haze in the background. Now, I should point out that even these expensive-looking locations aren't completely out of reach. Assuming that the Black Narcissus shot was done with a matte painting, none of these locations are really completely out of reach for low-budget filmmakers. It's really less about the location itself and more about the way the space is framed, the way the actors are staged, the choice of lens. When we shot these shots in the snow, Stephen Heller brought to my attention that there's really nothing in the foreground, which makes everything feel on the same plane in the shot, which makes everything feel really flat. So we asked one of my kids to just hold a branch in the frame to create the illusion of depth. And as we talked about in the previous course on directing, this obscuring element can also create a sense of voyeurism or intimacy. For some examples of how depth can improve a shot, check out the project chapters later in this course.